Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover ISRO Technical Assistant Vikram Sarabhai Space Center Trivandrum paper. Question 8, degrees of freedom for a robot is? Its answer is 6. Saving of metals is done in order to, from option, remove bore and improve accuracy. A is your correct answer. Saving is a finishing operation. Question is, when holes are required to be machined in several faces in small workpiece, it's box jig. Question is, major drawback of EDM process. In EDM process, from option, it's high capital cost. This is also one drawback. Power consumption is high. This is also drawback. Wear takes place at electrode at each part. This is also drawback. Metal removal rate is less. This is also one drawback. So here they ask for major drawback. Major drawback is here wear takes place at electrode at each spark. C is your best option. Question is, routing assist engineers in deciding an advanced flow of material in the plant. Routing, both manpower routing also you can do. Flow of material routing also you can do. So here, the method of proper utilization of manpower, then the methods of proper utilization of machine, the layout of factory facilities. Routing assist in layout of factory facilities. Question is, in a 2D CAD software, clockwise circular arc of radius 5, specified from P1, point 1 is, coordinates are 15, 10, then point 2 coordinates are 10 and 15. We will have its center. It's clockwise circular arc. So, let this is 5, then 10, then 15, 20, 5 units increment, 10, 15, 20, x-axis, y-axis. First P1, 15, x-coordinate is 15, y-coordinate is 10. So here, 15, 10, P1 coordinates are 15, 10. Then P2 coordinate is x-axis 10, y-axis 15. Here you will get P2, 10, 15. So clockwise circular arc, it will come like this. So I will change the color, red color. Your arc will come like this from P1 to P2. It's clockwise. So from P1 to P2, its center, it will come here. 5, 5. So here you will get 15 into 15, 15, 15. C is your correct answer. Question is, a rigid body shown in the figure A has a mass of 10 kg. It rotates with a uniform angular velocity omega. A balancing mass of 20 kg is attached as shown in figure B. The percentage increase in the mass moment of inertia as a result of this addition is how much? So case A and B, in both figure, two conditions are there. In case one, we know moment of inertia is mass into distance square. L is your distance, its square. In case one, or figure A, moment of inertia is mass is 10 into distance is 20, its square. It's 200 mm. No need to convert in meter. You just keep it is in 200 mm. So here you will get 10 into its square, 2 square, you will get 4, 4 into 10, it's 40, 40 into 10 to power 4, unit you will get kg, L is in mm, kg mm square you will get. Then in second case, I2 M1 L1 square plus M2 L2 square. M1 is 10 into 200 mm square plus M2 is 20 kg into distance is 100 square. So, if you solve this one, you will get 10 to the power 4 into 40 plus 20, 60 into 10 to the power 4 kg into mm square. Then we have to calculate the percentage of increase in mass moment of inertia. So, I2 minus I1 divided by I1. You will get 60 minus 40 divided by 40, 20 by 40. In percentage, it's 50%. So, 50% increase in mass moment of inertia. B is your correct answer. Least one and least two matching. Conduction, we know, Fourier law of conduction, Q equal to K dt by dx, Fourier law of conduction. So, A with double I, D you can cut, then convection, Newton's law of cooling, Q equal to HAS, TS minus T infinity. So B with IV, here B with IIII, B is your correct answer. You can cross check third one also. CC radiation with Stefan Boltzmann's law. B is your correct answer. Q equal to sigma A T to the power 4. So, from option B is your correct answer. Next question, question number 72. Equal volumes of all gases at the same temperature and pressure have the same number of molecules. This is Avogadro's law. Dalton's law for partial pressure. Charles' law is your V is proportional to temperature, and Boyle's law, P is inversely proportional to volume. So here Avogadro's law, equal volume of all gases at the same temperature and pressure have the same number of molecules. It's Avogadro's law. Question is, which of the following statements are true with respect to hydrostatic forces on a surface? In case of hydrostatic forces, total pressure is the force exerted by a static fluid on a surface, either plane or curved. This force is always acts normal to the surface. Yes, this is correct. The next one, in a vertical plane surface submerged in a liquid, the center of pressure lies below the center of gravity. Yes, this is also correct. We know if this is liquid level, first your H bar or center of gravity will come, then your H star or center of pressure will come. So, center of pressure lies below the center of gravity. This is correct. Then the distance of center of pressure from the free surface is independent of density of the liquid. Density is your rho. We know H star formula. I divided by A H bar plus H bar. So, here density is not available in this formula. So, it's independent of density. 3 also correct. So, A is your correct answer. Then, question number 75. First derivative of cot x into tan x. D by dx of cot x into tan x. You can write cot x is cos x divided by sin x into tan x sin x divided by cos x. So, d by dx of 1 is constant, it's 0. D is your correct answer. Then question number 76. Question is, a bag contains 5 red, 4 blue and 3 green balls. Find the probability of randomly drawing a red ball. Total number of balls are red ball is 5, blue ball is 4, green ball is 3. Randomly drawing, only one draw, red ball. So red ball is total is 5. Drawing one red ball out of 5 red ball, its probability of A is drawing one red ball out of 5 red balls. So 5C1, your sample space S is total 5 plus 4 plus 3, 12C1. So your probability of A equal to 5C1 divided by 12C1, 5 divided by 12. D is your correct answer. Question is 20C18. So we know NCR equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. So here N equal to 20, R equal to 18. 20C18, 20 factorial divided by 20 minus 18 factorial into 18 factorial. 20 factorial you can write 20 into 19 into 18 factorial. Here 2 factorial you can write 2 into 1 into, it's 18 factorial, 190. B is your correct answer. Question number 78, limit question. Limit theta tends to 0, sin 3 theta by sin 4 theta. Here, sin 0 by sin 0, 0 by 0 form. So you apply L'Hospital rule, do the differentiation. So, d by d theta of sin 3 theta, you will get 3, d by d theta of sin 4 theta, you will get 4. So limit theta tends to 0, after applying L'Hospital rule, you will get here 3 into sin 3 theta, you will get cos 3 theta, here 4 into, it's minus sin 4, no. cos 4 theta, 3 into cos 3 theta divided by 4 into cos 4 theta, 0 you put here, cos 0 by cos 0, 1 by 1, finally you will get 3 by 4, C is your correct answer. Just you apply the L'Hospital rule, then put the limit, theta tends to 0, cos theta will become 0, cos 0 by cos 0, 1 by 1, 3 by 4 you will get. Some basic math questions they are asking. So, d by d theta of sin theta, it's equal to cos theta. Then d by d theta of cos theta equal to minus sin theta. This one you have to use here. Here in this question, x value given, y value given, then dy by dx you have to calculate. So first dx by d theta you do, dx by d theta. Here from here you will get a theta minus a sin theta, y you will get a minus a cos theta. So dx by d theta, dA theta by d theta minus d by d theta of a sin theta, a will get minus a into cos theta, then dy by d theta, a is constant, you will get 0, after cos minus you will get minus minus cancel, a sin theta. So finally, we have to calculate dy by dx. you can write it as dy by d theta into d theta divided by dx. So dy by d theta, here we got it's a sin theta divided by d theta by dx. Here d theta by dx you will get 1 by a take common 1 minus cos theta. 1 minus cos theta. Sin theta divided by 1 minus cos theta. Sin theta divided by 1 minus cos theta. You will get it's cot theta by 2. A is your correct answer. This is also direct formula. Tan theta by 2 is your sin theta divided by 1 plus cos theta or 1 minus cos theta divided by sin theta. Cot 2 theta is sin theta divided by 1 minus cos theta or 1 plus cos theta divided by sin theta. A is your correct answer. Math questions are only basic question, mainly based on formulas. If you remember the basic formula, then you can solve them easily. From coordinate geometry, they are asking questions. Derivative, limit derivative, they are asking questions. Integration also, they may ask question. So here, length of major axis and minor axis of ellipse, we know. From ellipse equation, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. This is your equation of ellipse, and axis are 2a and 2b. A is your major axis. Here a square is 144. So a is, it's 12. Then b square is 121. B equal to 11. So A is greater than B. So A is your major axis. Then 2A, A is your half of the major axis. 2A is your major axis. 2A is 2 into 12. You will get 24. 2B, 2 into 11. You will get 22. So from option D is your correct answer. Coordinate geometry, just you remember the equation of line, then equation of circle, then ellipse. These three are important. From probability, this year they asked two questions. So probability also important. Then here, this is from differentiation. Then around 5-6 questions they are asking for mathematics. So mathematics basics you have to remember. This is the end of this part. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.